today we are going to be doing a really cool yet simple experiment that's going to show us just how important it is to wash our hands, and it's going to teach us all about germs. So this is our bread and mold experiment, and all you need for this is a loaf of bread, and I recommend using a fresh baker's loaf because you're going to see the results so much faster than if you use maybe the bread that you find in the typical bread aisle. And then you're also going to need 4 Ziploc bags, a Sharpie or permanent marker, and then also at some point you are going to need gloves or tongs. So once you have all these materials, we are ready to begin.
So the first thing you're going to want to do is grab 4 Ziploc bags. Make sure they can be sealed airtight, and you're going to want to label them. So you can just copy me here and label them dirty hand, clean hand, control, and dirty surface. So go ahead and pause your video and get these bags labeled. So the next step is to actually start putting your bread into the different bags. We're going to start with the control because that could be the most tricky. But before we start doing that, I do want to make a note about the bread. You can use any type of bread that you would like, but I will recommend using fresh baker's bread because it has less preservatives. So because of that reason, it will develop the mold quicker than any other type of bread that isn't fresh. So if you wanna have your results in a faster time, definitely use fresh bread. But if you don't mind waiting a while, you can use bread that you might already have at your house. So for the control, this is the most tricky because you wanna make sure the bread that you're getting out is as clean as possible. So what I'm going to do to make sure this is happening for me is using a glove. You can see I'm wearing a clean glove. So what I'm going to do is use my hand with the glove to grab the bread and only touch the bread with that hand and put it into the control bag very carefully, making sure it only touches the glove, and then sealing it up and then not touching it again. So go ahead and pause and carefully do this. If you don't have a glove, you can always use tongs. And so the next step is to do the dirty hand. So I've laid out my bread on the table and I haven't washed my hands yet. And I'm just going to press my hand, my dirty hand that hasn't been washed, into the bread a couple times. And then after I do that, I'm just going to put it in the bag and seal it up.
Now we are going to work on the clean hand, and before we do anything with the clean hand, we need to go wash our hands with warm water and soap for at least 20 seconds. So I'm going to go and wash my hands now. So after you have washed your hands just like I did, you scrub them really, really well, it's time to do the same thing that you have done with your dirty hand and press your hand onto the bread like here and then seal it up in your bag.
And then onto the last bag, the dirty surface bag. Here you can really do whatever you want. I'm going to rub my piece of bread all over the floor, and that's going to be my dirty surface, but you can rub it on a door handle, you can rub it on the bottom of your shoe, you can rub it anywhere that you think might be dirty, and that might really cause some germs to get on the bread. So go ahead and choose wherever you want to rub your bread onto, and then put it into the bag. So now that all of my bread are in their corresponding bags, what you want to do is make sure they're sealed up nice and tight, and then you really just want to find a safe spot to keep them where they won't get opened or touched or anything. So I have them sitting in my room for now. And then every day you're going to want to come back and check on them and see how they've changed or if they have changed. Maybe you could even write down some observations or things you notice. But really, you're just going to keep on checking on them after each day and see if you notice any changes in any of them throughout the time as it passes.
So I actually didn't observe any mold for the first few days,
However, by the seventh day, I was able to observe mold on both of my dirty hand pieces of bread and my dirty surface pieces of bread. And however, I did not see anything on my clean hand or my control just yet. And on the next day, the eighth day, I still didn't see anything on my control. My dirty hand had gotten a little bit more mold on the back. My clean hand actually observed some mold on the front and back. And then my dirty surface piece of bread had the most mold out of everyone. So again, as expected, I did not have anything on my control, but the mold did grow on all of the other pieces of bread. So it looks like the dirty and the clean hand are pretty similar, and then the dirty surface again has the most mold on it.
On the next day, which was the 10th day and also the last day I observed, you can see that all of the bread has developed a significant amount of mold besides the control. And I want to point out that I am a little bit disappointed in my clean hand piece of bread because it developed more mold than I hoped. And this could just be because I didn't scrub my hands well enough when I was washing them, or maybe because I rested it on my tablecloth, which might have had some germs on it. Either way, I challenge you guys to do better than I did and make sure you scrub your hands really hard so your clean piece of bread has less mold on it than mine did. Why did certain pieces of bread develop mold faster or in larger amounts than the others? Well, the dirty hand and the dirty surface were exposed to more germs than the clean hand and the control. This is why they developed the most mold the fastest. Although the clean hand developed a similar amount of mold as the dirty hand, it took a little bit longer for the mold to show up. This is because the clean hand had less germs on it than the dirty hand. This just goes to show how many germs are around us and how important it is to remember to wash your hands often. The book to pair with this experiment is called I Don't Want to Wash My Hands, and this is by Tony Ross. And if you tuned into our pepper soap experiment that we posted earlier, I recommended the book Wash Your Hands, and that was also by Tony Ross. So this is in that same collection, just a different book. So if you like that one, you will definitely like this one. So go ahead and check that out if you want. But otherwise, I hope you guys really enjoyed this and that you were able to see some results in your bread. Feel free to send your results in to us with the email that I will have on the end, as always. And I hope you guys have a great week, and we will see you next time.